Created in 1998, Gorillaz are a virtual band created by musician Damon Albarn and artist Jamie Hewlett that has secured their spot as the most successful virtual band in the world. Combining elements of hip-hop, alternative rock, electropop, and electronic music into a brilliant new sound. Gorillaz have set a precedent not only for virtual bands, but real ones as well. Fictitious band members Russell Hobbs, Murdoch Nichols, 2D, and Noodle keep us on our toes as they evolve in their ever-changing cartoon universe and bring us original and unique music and video content. Today, we are giving you 10 interesting facts about Gorillaz. The idea for the Gorillaz came to creators Damon Albarn and Jamie Hewlett when they were watching MTV. Hewlett explains the origins of the band, saying, "We're flatmates one day. We were home watching MTV with our eyes just kind of glazed. Because if you watch MTV for too long, it's a bit like hell. There's nothing of substance there. So we got this idea for a cartoon band, something that would be a comment on that." Albarn adds on to Hewlett, saying, "We're the generation whose stars come from Pop Idol and celebrity wrestling shows, and it's all a bit like a cartoon, really." Given Gorillaz's famous commentary on the artificial world of music, it is understandable why they derived their idea from MTV, which was a mini-universe of manufactured pop stars. The idea for Gorillaz also emerged out of the era of 90s boy bands, which were all the rage. Albarn and Hewlett found these bands to feel incredibly manufactured and almost fake despite their realness. So, they decided to take this idea and run with it, capitalizing off the fabricated essence of a band in a way that was almost a form of social commentary, and thus, Gorillaz was born out of irony. Given the fact that Gorillaz is entirely virtual, they have to get very creative when they perform live. Their tactics have evolved over the years, starting with some of their first shows, occurring throughout 2000 and 2002. The mechanics weren't great. The shows mostly consisted of Albarn performing behind a Technicolor screen, accompanied with blurry and pixelated visuals. Gorillaz upped their game with the release of their second album, Demon Days. At these shows, the cartoon band members could be seen in 3D forms with Albarn veiled behind a screen. But Albarn became tired of performing without the eyes of an audience, especially since he had been the lead singer in his band, Blur, prior to the Gorillaz. He explains the frustration, saying, "For someone who had just spent the last 10 years out in front being a frontman with Blur, it was a really weird experience, and I have to say, some nights I just wanted to get a knife and cut the screen and stick my head through." Eventually, with the release of Gorillaz's third and fourth album, Albarn did start taking center stage at concerts, alongside many guest performers, putting a spin on the usual all-virtual band. The cartoon members of the Gorillaz have elaborate backstories and personalities. Despite not actually being real people, Russell Hobbs, Murdoch Nichols, 2D, and Noodle have intricate lives. Let's walk through each band member's personality, starting with Russell Hobbs. Hobbs is the drummer and percussionist and was originally conceptualized by Albarn and Hewlett to be the personification of the Gorillaz' hip-hop elements. Some fun facts about Hobbs is that he is from Brooklyn. He was possessed by the spirits of dead musicians. He has been captured by the North Korean government, and he joined Gorillaz after being kidnapped by Murdoch Nichols. Nichols is Gorillaz' bassist, who was actually based on the Rolling Stones' Keith Richards, Frankenstein, and Creeper from Scooby-Doo. He is known as the villain of the band. Nichols is a Satanist, has been arrested for counterfeit checks, and is responsible for putting 2D in a coma. 2D, or Stuart Harold, is the lead vocalist and keyboardist for the Gorillaz. He is incredibly injury-prone. He received his nickname from the two dents in his head caused by flying through a car windshield. He has also fractured both his eyes and has fallen from a tree. Lastly is Noodle, who is the Gorillaz' lead guitarist. Some facts about Noodle are that she lost her memory after being part of a super-secret government program, regained these memories after hearing the words Ocean Bacon, and was shipped to the US in a FedEx crate by the government to be part of the Gorillaz. When talking about gorillas, you must discuss Remy Kabaka Jr. Although many people have helped gorillas in orchestrating such complex and elaborate music and cartoon universe, Kabaka truly deserves much of the applause. Kabaka started off working with gorillas as the voice of Russell Hobbs, but eventually moved on to be the drummer and co-producer for the band. He is credited as an official member of the band, in addition to creators Damon Albarn and Jamie Hewlett. Kabaka was especially important in gathering up the guests for Gorillaz' 2017 album, Humans. Kabaka explains what this process was like and his experience working with Albarn, saying, "Well, Damon and I always talk about music, old and new, and that helped inform the choices and themes around the album. He said he wanted a Chicago flavor to it, hence getting Pevin Everett, Twilight Tone, and Jamie Principle. The others were people whose sounds we liked and thought they would be good voices or characters for the album. It's a pretty organic process. We chose people who have something to say at that time, like Danny Brown, Vince Staples, Cali Uchis, and Zebra Cats. The record was about the future in that sense." Gorillaz is meant to represent the paradox of being completely artificial and thus less artificial than commercial bands. Hewlett explains this concept, saying, "If you're going to pretend to be somebody you're not, which is the whole point of being a rock star, then why not just invent fake characters and have them do it all for you?" Albarn adds on, saying, "I hope we can keep doing it this way, making music and art that are pure products of our influences while not really having to let the whole celebrity side of it get in the way. Then maybe more virtual bands will come out and do the same thing. And then hopefully there will be so many of us that people will start asking themselves, what in the world is going on here? We're buying magazines full of cartoons." This originality is why the Gorillaz stand out in the world of alternative rock, hip-hop, and electronic music. Not only does the band visually stick out because they're cartoon forms, but they are also constantly making a statement on the absurdity of fame by merely existing. It is truly a brilliant concept that allows for endless musical avenues. Gorillaz' fourth studio album, The Fall, was recorded entirely on Damon Albarn's iPad while he was on the North American leg of the band's Escape to the Plastic Beach tour. The album was digitally released on Christmas Day in 2010 and made available for download for members of Gorillaz' fan club. It had a larger and physical release in April of 2011. Albarn explains the recording process and his decision to release the album digitally on Christmas Day. "I literally made it on the road. I didn't write it before. I didn't prepare it. I just did it day by day as a kind of diary of my experience in America. If I left until the new year to release it, then the cynics out there would say, 'Oh, well, I've been tampered with.' But I put it out now, they'd know that I haven't done anything because I've been on tour ever since." Given the fact that he was on the road, Albarn had access to only a few instruments in addition to his iPad. However, it still managed to receive great reviews for its experimental elements, although critics did comment on it feeling different from previous Gorillaz albums. Damon Albarn and Jamie Hewlett wrote an opera. Although not officially classified as a Gorillaz project, Albarn has said that the project was Gorillaz, but they can't call it that for legal reasons. The opera is in Mandarin and was written over the course of multiple trips to China. It is based on the classical Chinese novel titled Journey to the West and is about a monkey who desires immortality and his journey to enlightenment. Hewlett explains the origins of the project, saying, "We didn't have any idea it would be quite this large scale when we started. We originally thought it'd be 6 months' work, and it ended up taking, well, 3 years from when we first sort of went to China." Albarn adds on, saying, "We're moving upwards in one way of looking at it, but I think we're just sort of moving around. We've had some interesting meetings while we've been here in the States. Once you've done something on this scale, it sends a message to a lot of people that you can work on that scale." Once Albarn and Hewlett completed this project, they returned to working on musical release under the Gorillaz name. Horror movie imagery inspires much of Damon Albarn and Jamie Hewlett's work for Gorillaz. When asked where this zombie fascination comes from and why it incorporated into the fictitious world of the Gorillaz, Albarn responded saying, "Well, because everybody on TV is a fucking zombie, right? I mean, watch a 50 Cent video where he's in the middle of a club and he's just surrounded by zombies. the Gorillaz cartoon seems more real to me than the actual people on TV, because at least you know that there's some intelligence behind the cartoons, and there's a lot of work that's gone into it, so it can't all just be a lie. Hewlett also is largely responsible for this imagery. He explains, saying, "But the whole zombie thing is an obsession of mine. I love zombie films. Once I looked out the window where I worked and realized that everybody was walking around in circles with their mobile phones attached to their heads. It reminded me of the scene from Dawn of the Dead in the car a lot. This was a big inspiration. The incorporation of zombie imagery throughout the Gorillaz music and virtual world is very much in line with Albarn and Hewlett's desire to capture the paradox of their artificial band." In addition to horror imagery, Albarn and Hewlett also take inspiration from different cultures for the music of Gorillaz. Albarn explains the cultural influence for Demon Days, saying, "I came back with lots of inspiration from Mongolia. There was one moment in particular that inspired some of the darker elements of Demon Days. I bought lots of old Betty Boop cartoons with really bad, aggressive Chinese overdubs and watched them with my daughter on a train traveling through northern China. The area is utterly destroyed by all the farming. There was a 200-mile stretch where all the trees were dead. The scene felt totally apocalyptic." Hewlett's artwork for Demon Days was also inspired by his cultural surroundings. He says, "I took a lot of influences from Studio Ghibli, which is this Japanese animation studio that made Spirited Away and Castle in the Sky. They're like the Japanese version of Disney, but without all the schmaltz. They make beautiful films that are also a bit dark, which is how I want Gorillaz animation to turn out. Another influence was the knockoff art that you see in Mexico. They've got such an eye for color and design. I love it." Their 2020 project, Song Machine, is a music video web series. Departing from the traditional album format, Song Machine releases music videos and singles monthly as episodes with a guest feature. Each episode contains Machine Bites, which are various skits of conversations between the guests and Gorillaz virtual band members. Sometimes episodes which also include short descriptions about the making of Song Machine. The idea for the album was born out of Albarn's frustration with waiting the months that it takes to release an album, and, therefore, wanted to try a different approach. Albarn talks about the experience of creating such a unique project, saying, "It's one of the best albums I've ever made. It's really strong because every tune has that single intention to it. To make an album of singles is such a rigorous pursuit, you don't normally do it, but accidentally, we have. The coolest part of the Song Machine has got to be the guests, Elton John, Schoolboy Q, The Cure's Robert Smith, and St. Vincent are just some of the few stars that appear on the episodes. The episodes were released as a full studio album called Song Machine, Season 1, Strange Times. And we are expecting Season 2 very shortly. Well, that's all for today, everyone. We hope you enjoyed the video, and we'll see you next time.